Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Friday, the Feast of the Most Sacred Heart. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The designs of his heart are from age to age, to rescue their souls from death, and to keep them alive in famine.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate today the Feast of the Sacred Heart, we turn to the Lord's mercy, acknowledge our need for His forgiveness, His love, and mercy. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who glory in the heart of your beloved Son and recall the wonders of his love for us may be made worthy to receive an overflowing measure of grace from the fount of heavenly gifts. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "You are a people sacred to the Lord your God. He has so chosen you from all the nations on the face of the earth to be a people peculiarly his own. It was not because you are the largest of all nations that the Lord set his heart on you and chose you. For you are really the smallest of all nations. It was because the Lord loved you and because of his fidelity to the oath he had sworn your fathers that he brought you out with his strong hand from the place of slavery and ransomed you from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Understand then that the Lord your God is God indeed, the faithful God who keeps his merciful covenant down to the thousandth generation toward those who love him and keep his commandments, but who repays with destruction a person who hates him. He does not dally with such a one, but makes them personally pay for it. You shall therefore carefully observe the commandments, the statutes, and the decrees that I enjoin on you today." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him."
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. All my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes.
The Lord's kindness is everlasting to those who fear him.
The second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent His only Son into the world so that we might have life through Him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we must also love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and His love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in Him and He in us, that He has given us of His Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that the Father sent His Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in Him and He in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love of God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Take my yoke upon you, says the Lord, and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus exclaimed, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we celebrate the Feast of the Sacred Heart. No, probably it's one of the most popular devotions, no, in all over the world, but especially I think in the Philippines, no. Isa sa mga, 'di ba, sabi nga ho nila, halos lahat ng bahay ng Pilipino may Sacred Heart, no. Bukod sa imahe ng Mahal na Birhen at ng krus, yung Sacred Heart ang pinaka siguro sa halos lahat ng mga bahay ng Pilipino, merong imahe ng Sacred Heart, no. And I think it's a very beautiful devotion because it expresses our faith in the love and mercy of God. I think that's a very good expression of our faith. But let me just begin our reflections for the Feast of the Sacred Heart, taking a look at the first part of today's gospel. Kung tignan ninyo yung unang bahagi ng gospel, di ba sabi niya, I give you praise, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because tinago mo to sa mga marunong, sa mga pantas, at sinawalat mo, you revealed it to the little ones, no? And I think here it's really not an insult to the experts or the scholars, but the Lord is saying, you know, in the end, it's not just knowledge in terms of intellectual knowledge, but again, we go back to that whole point. It's a relationship with God, no? And here, the Lord clearly puts the value on the virtue of humility, no? And I guess, you know, every time we approach God, every time na tayo ay lumalapit sa Diyos, natural na meron tayong pagpapakumbaba, meron tayong humility, no? Because, no, His love is so overwhelming. Yung humility is hindi ka nanliliit, pero yung bang na naramdaman mo na, oo nga, ano, nakaasa ako sa Kanya, I am totally dependent on God's love. And I think that is the humility that the Lord is talking about, no? So that's the first introduction, no, in the gospel, no, that humility of acknowledging that God is the source of all grace and love, no. Yung second is, if you notice, the Lord claims here that He is the Son, that He knows the Father. This is one of the early claims that He makes in the Gospel of Matthew, that He is the Son of God and that He knows the Father very intimately, no. And then that second part, that beautiful, and I would like to focus on this for our reflection, that beautiful invitation of the Lord, come to me all you who are weary, who labor and are burdened. Again, it assures us of Christ always being there for us, especially during moments of many challenges and many stresses in our lives. No? And of course, he has that image, you know, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. You know, there is a legend that Jesus is supposedly the son of the carpenter. And there is a legend that the Lord, one of the crafts of the Lord was that he would make the yoke, diba, yung para sa do sa mga animal, diba, for the animals during that is used either for transportation or in farming. But according to the legend, he was such a good yoke maker that every time magpapagawa ka ng yoke para sa iyong donkey or anuman or oxen, yung fit ng yoke ay tamang-tama. So kaya parang magaan at maganda yung fit, kaya nakakatrabaho ng gusto ng maayos yung hayop, ano? And I guess the Lord is saying here that I will not ask you to do something that is not part of your mission. And if I ask you to do something, I will provide you with all the graces. I will provide you with my companionship. I will provide you with my fidelity, diba? With my loving providence and presence as you do your mission. And that is what I invite you to reflect on today on the Feast of the Sacred Heart. You know, we are in a situation wherein the world is in need of so much healing. We are certainly in a situation that can once more be renewed by the grace and love of God. And on this Feast of the Sacred Heart, let us ask first of all the heart of our Lord to renew us in our mission, that we may become His companions, His partners, His co-missionaries in healing our world. And to have that faith, as He says in today's gospel, diba? Tayo ho ay manampalataya. Yung sinasabi niya sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, na ako ay lagi ninyong kasama. Ako ay hindi ko kayo pababayaan, sapagkat ang pinagkatiwala ko sa inyong misyon ay alam kong kaya ninyong gawin. Come to me all you who are weary and find life burdensome, and I will refresh you. Take my yoke upon your back, for my yoke is easy and my burden light. And I think the reason why that is easy and the burden is light is because Christ is there. Christ, this is Christ's mission. He gave it to us. We will say yes, but He will bring it to completion. Yun ho ang ating panalangin at yun ho ang ating pananampalataya ngayon sa kapistahan ng mahal na puso ni Jesus, na ang ating misyon ay galing sa Diyos. Mula sa Diyos, ang magtatapos po ay ang Diyos. And He will always be with us in living out this mission. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And together now, let us profess our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
And let us now bring our prayers and petitions to the Lord. Let us pray first of all for the world, that on this Feast of the Sacred Heart, the world may be healed and renewed through the love and mercy of the heart of Christ. For this let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the church, that it may continue to be a source of hope, a source of healing for the world, that through the sacrifice of our Lord, the church may become channels of the grace of God's mercy and healing. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our families during this Feast of the Sacred Heart, that we may consecrate our families to the love, to the mercy of Christ. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our country, especially for the poor who have suffered the most during this pandemic, that the healing love of the heart of Christ may heal our country and heal our people. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we ask you again to join us in praying for the renewal of the franchise of ABS. And so together we pray.
Loving Father, our risen Lord and most Holy Spirit, you guide all the affairs of men and women of goodwill. We thank you for the gift of mission to ABS-CBN to be in the service of the Filipino. We thank you for blessing ABS-CBN's work, most especially with the millions of Filipinos and friends who are one with ABS-CBN in its mission. We in ABS-CBN pray that with grateful hearts, we will strive to be better, continuing to improve on the service we render and correcting our failures and shortcomings. We turn to you now, one in prayer, faith, and hope, in ABS-CBN's need, humbly asking that you send your spirit to guide all our leaders in the executive and judicial branches of government, and most especially our congressmen and women and our senators, that they may conduct a fair and truthful hearing and come to a decision that is for the greater good of the greater majority of the Filipino people and of our world, and what is for your greater glory. We ask this through the intercession of Our Lady of Fatima, and in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, O Lord, we pray, on the surpassing charity in the heart of your beloved Son, that what we offer may be a gift acceptable to you and an expiation of our offenses, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love and poured out body and water from his spear's side, the wellspring of the church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now with confidence turn to God and offer to him the prayer that our Lord Jesus taught us.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May this sacrament of charity, O Lord, make us fervent with the fire of holy love, so that drawn always to your Son, we may learn to see him in our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
So happy feast day of the Sacred Heart.